It is now my unique privilege to bring to you an individual who over the past 7 years has worked tirelessly to shape the global agenda for the world we want. That agenda promotes equality, concern for the next generation, our planet, and partnerships. Since the WEPs 2010 launch, the Secretary General continues to be the essential WEPs champion, leading by example. What an honor, ladies and gentlemen, it is to present the United Nations Secretary General, Mr. Ban Ki-moon.
Thank you very much for your kind welcome. And I'd like to, first of all, thank Ms. Lise Kingo, Executive Director of UN Global Compact and UN Women, for organizing this very important gathering. And thank you also, Ms. Elizabeth Bodrick and Mr. Joseph Kiefe, co-chairs of Women's Empowerment Principles and Leadership Group. I'm honored also to be joined also by Ms. Fiza Farhan, CEO of Bosch Foundation and Director of Bosch Energy Private Limited, who is also a member of my high-level panel on women's economic empowerment, which I participated this morning. Excellencies, distinguished leaders of business and industry, ladies and gentlemen, it's my great pleasure to join you at the 2016 Women's Empowerment Principles Annual Event at the 60th Commission of Status of Women. I thank the UN Global Compact again and UN Women for bringing us together to such a dynamic group to shine the light on how business can advance gender equality. I'm pleased to see the Women's Empowerment Principles event as part of the CSW. I hope it will continue to provide an entry point for business going forward. This is a critically important CSW session because it falls in the first year of the 2030 agenda, as well as the Paris Agreement on climate change. They say that making a good start is equally to doing half the job. So I think we are beginning very good step this year. So this year is especially crucial. I really count on your strong engagement and leadership. We cannot achieve sustainable development goals without securing full and equal rights of half of the world's population. In law and in practice, women can drive climate action. They also can be drivers of change of our society. When companies invest in women, they see a range of benefits and the return on investment. It is clear that gender equality is a business issue. The Global Compact Women's Empowerment Principle constitutes the largest initiative for business and gender equality. The principles are comprehensive and practical, and they are already having an impact around the world. The growth of women's empowerment principles over the past 6 years is a testament to their value. When we launched this initiative in 2010, I spoke to a small committed group. Now, the Women's Empowerment Principle count more than 1,100 CEO signatories from 80 countries. What a great stride which we have made. They represent all industries and all regions. The women's empowerment principles have inspired concrete policies and practices that are empowering women in business operations, hiring, training, contracting, and procurement. The principles have also helped the business work more closely with the UN to reach our common goals of ensuring equality, achieving the 2030 agenda, and advancing climate action. I thank all of you for this significant progress. Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, I welcome the many participating CEOs who are providing innovative solutions to the challenges facing women. I'm especially impressed to hear from a leader from the next generation, Ms. Fiza Farhan, a young female entrepreneur from Pakistan, from whom we have just heard. I'm proud to have her serve on my high-level panel on women's economic empowerment. Ms. Farhan's story is so important because she is a part of the largest generation of youth in history. The Sustainable Development Goals are for them. We will never achieve these goals without tapping into the energy, talent, expertise of young women and girls. I really count on each of you to align your operations with the women's empowerment principles and take bold action to ensure gender equality. Since I'm here with all the business CEOs and members of the women's empowerment principle, I'd like to add what I'm thinking, which is very important. This morning, as I said, with the president of Costa Rica and also the CEO of IKEA Switzerland, I established about 20 people high-level panel on gender, women's economic empowerment. I think this is in line with what you are doing. I think this there should be a principle that there should be no differences between what men do and what women do. One of the top priorities of establishing this high-level panel on women's economic empowerment is that in laws, as I just said, in laws and politics, I think we have talked a lot. And there is a much heightened awareness worldwide about the gender equality, gender empowerment. But that we have been speaking all the times, and nobody disagrees. That's the good things we have come. But 6 years or 7 years, we have been speaking all the times. What is unacceptable, unjust, and is that inequality between men and women in economic, real economy. When it comes to salaries, for example, they work in the same factory, they make the same quality goods, and they sell. But there is no difference between this is manufactured by women or manufactured by men. They just buy from a company. But the salaries that women receive is minimum 25% less. Just the 3/4 they receive. And depending upon the workplaces, much lower than even 2/3. So that is unjust, that is inequality. We have to rectify this kind of inequality. I think this is what you have to do in accordance with women's empowerment principles. You have to change this one. There may be many ways. We are really trying to change this injustice, inequality, which are being imposed on women. I have been since, as I said yesterday during the opening session, since day one, even before I took over this one, I have been really working very hard. This global compact is a very important tool. You have a very important means. You have the power now. Use these means and power to enhance and change this situation. And I really count on your continuing leadership on this. This will help achieve a life of dignity for all the people living on a safe and peaceful and sustainably prosperous planet. And this is the vision of sustainable development goals, which were adopted last year by world leaders. Now, our mission, our job, is to implement the fully by 2030. By 2030, there should be no inequality, no injustice when it comes to men and women. This, we should live in 50-50 planet by 2030. Thank you very much. Thank you.